Ready for Johnny Cash?
No. Oh boy.
Oh boy, Daddy sang bass.
I remember when I was a lad, times were hard and things were bad. But there's a silver lining behind every cloud. Just poor people, that's all we were, trying to make a living out of black lantern. We'd get together in a family circle singing loud. Daddy sang bass. Singing seems to help a troubled soul. One of these days, and it won't be long, I'll rejoin them in a song. I'm gonna join the family circle at the throne. No, the circle won't be broken. By and by, Lord, by and by. Daddy, you sing bass.
Mama, sing tonight.
Me and little brother will join right in. In the sky.
Turn the music up.
Now I remember after work, Mama would call in all of us.
It's a Chevy Impala right over there. Let's turn the music up. Love Johnny Cash.
Daddy sang bass.
Mama sang tenor.
Singing seems to help a troubled soul. One of these days, and it won't be long, I'll rejoin them in a song. I'm gonna join the family circle at the throne. Oh, the circle won't be broken. By and by, Lord, by and by. Daddy sing bass.
Mama sing tenor.
Me and little brother will join right in. In the sky, Lord, in the sky. In the sky, Lord, in the sky.
Next, a boy named Sue.
One okay. Yep, yours.
11.
Well, my daddy left home when I was 3, and he didn't leave much to Ma and me. Just this old guitar and an empty bottle of booze. Now, I don't blame him because he run and hid, but the meanest thing that he ever did was before he left, he went and named me Sue. Well, he must have thought that it was quite a joke, and it got a lot of laughs from lots of folks. It seems I had to fight my whole life through.
Yeah.
Some gal would giggle and I'd get red, and some guy'd laugh and I'd bust his head. I'll take it. Life ain't easy for a boy named Sue. Well, I grew up quick and I grew up mean. My fists got hard and my wits got keen. Roamed from town to town to hide my shame. But I made me a vow to the moon and stars. I'd search the honky-tonks and bars and kill that man and give me that awful name. Well, it was Gatlinburg in mid-July, and I'd just hit town, and my throat was dry. I thought I'd stop and have myself a brew. At an old saloon in a street of mud, there at a table, dealing stud, sat a dirty major dog that named me Sue. Well, I knew that snake was my own sweet dad from a worn-out picture that my mother had. And I knew that scar on his cheek and his evil eye. He was big and fat and gray and old. I looked at him and my blood ran cold. I said, my name is Sue. How do you do?
How are you gonna die?
Yeah, that's what I told him. Well, I hit him hard right between the eyes. He went down, but to my surprise, come up with a knife and cut off a piece of my ear. Well, I busted a chair right across his teeth, and we crashed through the wall and into the street, kicking and a-gouging in the mud and the blood for beer. I tell you, I fought tougher men, but I really can't remember when. He kicked like a mule and he bit like a crocodile. I heard him laugh and then I heard him cuss. He went for his gun to pull mine first. He stood there looking at me. I saw him smile. He said, son, this world is rough, and if a man's gonna make it, he's gotta be tough. And I know I wouldn't be there to help you along. Oh, I give you that name and I said goodbye. I knew you'd have to get tough or die. And it's that name that helped to make you strong. Yeah. He said, now you just fought one hell of a fight. And I know you hate me and you got the right to kill me now. And I wouldn't blame you if you do. But you ought to thank me before I die for the gravel in your guts and the spit in the eye. Cause I'm the that named you Sue. I got all choked up and I threw down my gun. Called him a paw and he called me a son. And I come away with a different point of view. And I think about him now and then every time I try.
Saw the car lights.
And if I ever have a son, I think I'm gonna name him Bill or George, anything but Sue. Well, I woke up Sunday morning.
One piece at a time, here we go. Here we go.
Well, I left Kentucky back in 49 and went to Detroit working on assembly line. The first year they had me putting wheels on Cadillacs. Every day I'd watch them beauties roll by, and sometimes I'd hang my head and cry. Cause I always wanted me one that was long and black. One day I devised myself a plan that should be the envy of most any man. I'd sneak it out of there in the lunchbox in my head. Now getting caught meant getting fired, but I figured I'd have it all by the time I retired. I'd have me a car worth at least $100,000. I'd get it one piece at a time, and it wouldn't cost me a dime. You know it's me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around in style, I'm gonna drive everybody wild, cause I'll have the only one there is around. So the very next day when I punched in with my big lunchbox and with help from my friend, I left that day with a lunchbox full of gear. I've never considered myself a thief, but GM would miss just one little piece, especially if I strung it out over several years. The first day I got me a fuel pump, and the next day I got me an engine and a trunk, then I got me a transmission and all the chrome. The little things I could get in the big lunchbox, like nuts and bolts and all four shocks, but the big stuff we stuck out my buddy's mobile home. Up to now my plan went all right till we tried to put it all together one night, and that's when we noticed that something was definitely wrong. The transmission was a 53 and the motor turned out to be a 73, and when we tried to put in the bolts all the holes were gone. So we drilled it out so that it would fit, and with a little bit of help from an adapter kit, we had that engine running just like a song.
Volvo truck.
Now the headlights, there was another sight. We had two on the left and one on the right. But when we pulled out the switch, all three of them come on. The back end looked kind of funny too, but we put it together and when we got through, well, that's when we noticed that we only had one tail fin. About that time, my wife walks out and I could see in her eyes that she had her doubts. But she opened the door and said, honey, take me for a spin. So we drove uptown just to get the tags, and I headed to ride on the down main drag. I could hear everybody laughing for blocks around. But up there at the courthouse, they didn't laugh, cause to type it up, it took the whole staff. And when they got through, the title weighed 60 pounds. I got it one piece at a time, and it didn't cost me a dime. You'll know it's me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around in style, I'm gonna drive everybody wild, cause I'll have the only one there is around.
You've got power.
Yeah, Red Rider, this is Cottonmouth in the Psycho Billy Cadillac. Come on. Oh, this is a Cottonmouth, a negatory on the cost of this machine there, Red Rider. You might say I went right up to the factory and picked it up. It's cheaper that way. What model is it? Well, it's 49, 50, 51, 52, 53,
ghost riders in the sky.
That old cowboy went riding out one dark and windy day. Up on a ridge he rested as he went along his way. When all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw plowing through the ragged skies. And up a cloudy draw, their brands were still on fire and their hooves were made of steel. Their horns were black and shiny and their hot breath he could feel. A bolt of fear went through him as they
passed. This mid-city motor world.
For he saw the riders coming hard and he heard their mournful cry.
Bus. Oh, Lord. NorCal bus authorities.
Their faces gaunt, their eyes blurred. Their shirts all soaked with sweat. He's riding hard to catch that herd, but he ain't caught them yet. Cause they've got to ride forever on that range up in the sky. All the horses snort and fire as they ride on, hear their cry. As the rider floated on by him, he heard one call his name. If you wanna save your soul from hell, ride
at this target.
Then cowboy, change your ways. If they are with us, you will ride. Trying to catch the devil's herd across these endless skies. Yippee-yi-yo.
I do not know.
Start over again?
Yeah.
Or do you want to listen to